Welcome to Design in a Minute, brought to you by www.interiordesign.com, the premier interior design website on the internet. Today's Design in a Minute is about colour and light. Now, the natural daylight we see is clear or white light. It consists of all the colours in the visible spectrum. So how do we get colour from white light? Well, what actually happens is that the colour that the object is, i.e. its pigment, absorbs all light except for that colour which is reflected back and what is what we see. The following pictures are examples of objects in their natural state with white light on them and then with different colours of light shining on them. It's a very stark difference without the actual white light. Removing some colours from the white light gives different effects in colours displayed or reflected back. So what's all this mean? Well, white light is not white light at all, but the result of all colours from the light spectrum. This was discovered and proved by Sir Isaac Newton through an experiment he did. In 1666, it's the same year as the plague and the Great Fire of London, Newton conducted an experiment using a hole in a window shade to emit a ray of daylight into a dark room through a prism. The result was that the light was refracted or bent when travelling through the prism and came out as a spreading beam of multicoloured light, these being the colours of the rainbow and in the same order. Newton concluded that the white light was a mixture of different types of light, each being a single pure colour. Each colour was bent at different degrees, violet the most and red the least. These colours he identified as red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo and violet. And each hue is today thought to correspond to a portion of the range of wavelengths of radiant energy that can be distinguished by the human eye. This is the visible spectrum. It's only a tiny proportion of the whole electromagnetic spectrum, which ranges from high energy X-rays to low energy radio waves. At either end of the visible spectrum is black or white, and white reflects and contains all the colours within it, and black absorbs all colour. Now, Newton continued the experiment and found that by introducing a converging lens after the prism, the lens would mix the colours and white light was achieved once more. He also experimented further by blocking out some colours and recombining others, creating coloured mixtures of light. These colours were quite different from any found in the naturally occurring spectrum. He then introduced a converging lens after the prism which mixed the colours to achieve white light again. The conclusion was that the colour of everything in nature depends on the type of light it sends to the eye. This also depends on the individual colours of the light that the surface of the object reflects, absorbs or transmits, and the nature of the light falling on the object. Sounds difficult, doesn't it? But generalising, if a surface looks strongly coloured when viewed in white light, it is reflecting certain colours and absorbing others. We view a red Ferrari on the street, it has absorbed all forms of light except red, which it reflects back to us to tell us that it is red. That's it. So for much more on colour and colour schemes, decorating or anything to do with interior design, visit us at www.interiordesign.com, and that's with a Z. Oh, and help us to help you help others. Tell friends and family about this site. It's free education and they'll be grateful. Interiordesign.com, the internet's premier interior design website.